In the next chapter, I'm going to teach you to insert walls in Revit. My goal is to explain each step slowly and make sure that everything stays clear in your mind. That's very important. The command wall is located here in the Architecture tab. Click on it. Now, on the Properties panel at the left, you can see this image of the wall section with the different materials that compound the wall. If I click there, I can choose a different wall type from the ones loaded by default. Let's keep the same, because first I want to explain the process of drawing a wall. Click for the start point. Then you have to click again for the end point. I'm going to move the cursor a bit down, and as soon as I am near to the horizontal axis, this track line shows up with the label saying horizontal. Click to place the wall, and then you notice that I can place another one right away. This time let's make it vertical, and like before, the line snaps to the vertical direction. Next, I'm going to draw a third wall, also horizontal, but this time I will find this intersection between track lines, so both horizontal walls will be equal. Finally, I need to draw another vertical wall to make a close boundary. And look that if I click on this endpoint, Revit will make the wall join automatically. Okay, now as I have finished, I press Escape to stop drawing a wall from the last point, and if you want to exit the command, press Escape again. Okay, I am going to select the four walls. Let's open a selection area to cover them all and press Delete to erase the walls. Then I'm going to show you about placing a wall with a specific length. Place the start point and draw a horizontal wall, and above you can see this length appearing here. If you are used to AutoCAD, here in Revit is a bit different, because if you click right now, the length will be exactly 1700 mm. Now place a vertical wall. Then, instead of clicking, I'm going to type a specific length, 2000, and press Enter. Press Escape, select the wall, and you can see the measurement showing up in this temporary dimension. Now, pay attention to this. These distances are based on the wall's original design. Look, when you click on the vertical wall, the 2000 mm is between these two points, and then this wall join is created automatically. Now, I want to introduce to you the length dimension increments, which is the way I insert the length by only dragging the pointer. They depend on the current zoom of the window. Now, let's zoom out a lot, and you can see that now the dimension increases every 1000 meters. Then, I'm going to zoom a little bit. At this moment, the values change in a smaller range, this time in intervals of 100 between each measurement. Zoom in a bit more, and move closer to the start point, and you can see that the values are now snapping every 20 millimeters. All these settings are editable in the snaps, located on the Manage tab. In this window, the section above is exactly what I was talking about before, the length dimension snap increments. It indicates the ranges that I am using. The first value is 1000. This was the interval when I was too far. Then at a certain moment, it snaps only every 100 meters, and so on. So, you can edit these values according to what makes more sense in your current project. Okay, now it's time for a little exercise. But first, let's change the visual style here. Currently, we are in the wireframe, but I prefer to have some colors here. For example, consistent colors. With this, it's easy to recognize the layers of the wall structure better. Let's start drawing. Another way to insert a wall in the project is by selecting one of the walls, right-click, and choose Create Similar. I'm going to place the pointer at the right side, and find this track line in order to have both figures aligned. So, for the first wall, I'm going to type 5000 and press enter. The next one is vertical and I type 2800. Then find again the horizontal track line, type 3100. This one is 3845. Then I just need to go to the left and find this track line. Click. And connect it to the origin. Okay, now you could ask, in order to allow the join, should I click on this point at the middle, or would it work also in this one? Actually, it doesn't matter. Since your point touches the origin of that wall, it will work. However, it wouldn't make the join if you push your wall up to here, and then this would be the result. Let's go to the next section. I want to open a 3D view to notice how the project looks like in a 3D perspective. Let's double click on the default 3D view, this one. Okay, this is how it looks like. And as you can remember, we haven't specified any height for the walls. I'm going to select a wall. And if you go to the properties, you can notice that the height says unconnected and it measures 8000 mm. So, before doing any change here, I want to explain to you how the levels work in Revit. In our floor plan level 0, we have an elevation for each Cartesian axis, west, north, east, and south elevations. As our example, we are going to use the south elevation, which is the perspective from this side. Let's open it from the project browser. Double click here. Now we can see both drawings, and we have currently two levels created in this project. Let's consider the level 0 as the ground floor and the level 1 as the first floor. Now, to be easier to visualize the levels, I want to extend the level lines beyond the drawings. So, try to find this little circle next to the level symbol. It says, drag the extents of the level in the model. Click and hold, and move to the left. Repeat the process for the other extremity, and as you could notice, the level 0 followed the level 1. This happened because of this constraint, represented by this lock. If you click there, the lock opens, and this time I could extend one of the levels separately. Now press Ctrl Z to go back. Okay, now I'm going to teach you to set the heights for each level. The level 0, we are going to leave it in the elevation 0, but I want to change the level 1, and this is actually pretty easy. Select it. Click on this dimension, and change the value to 3000 mm. Great! Now let's create a new level. To do this, we have to go to the Architecture tab, move the pointer towards the Datum panel, and select Level. Now place the pointer aligned with the level symbols, and move up until this distance is the one that I want, 3000. Click to place the level tool. Now move to the right side and place the opposite extremity aligned with the others. Press Escape twice to exit the command. And now I'm going to rename each level. Let's start with the level 2 and let's put, for example, roof level. Now I get this message. Would you like to rename the corresponding views? This means that the names in the project browser will also change. Yes, I want. And I'm going to tick this box, because I don't want to get this message all the time. Then the level 1 is the first floor, and the level 0, we are going to name it as ground floor. Now for the height of the walls, as currently they are unconnected and measure 8 meters, I want to change them to go up to the roof level. Here, the best is to switch to the floor plan, I'm going to select all the objects. And now you can notice here multiple categories selected. I'm going to click on Common and select just the walls. Now I need to go to the parameter Top Constraint and change Unconnected to up to level 2. So the walls will go only up to the roof level. And you can confirm your changes when you open the source elevation. Back in the ground floor, maybe you have noticed that the second image does not have the layers displayed in the same way comparing with the first drawing. But don't worry, because it's easy to flip the wall to the other side. Just select, for example, this one and press the spacebar. It's easy. Now just select all the others with the selection area, press space again, and now the drawing is correct. Now, the next thing, I'm going to talk about the wall location line. Up till here, we were using the default option, which was the wall center line. As you can see, the track line was exactly in the middle of the wall. Now, if you look at the options bar, this menu that shows up every time we insert any element in our project, we can see that one of the options is the location line, currently set as wall center line. If you click there, and you can see that we can change to a different position. You can see different options. Now let's choose, for example, the finish face exterior. If I draw a wall here, this time the location line is at the exterior side where the brick layer is. Instead, if I pick up interior, now it's located at the side facing the interior of the building. Also, there is an option called core face, both exterior and interior, where it only considers the wall structure. The next thing, we are going to insert interior walls here in this example. And from time to time, Revit reminds you to save the project. This is a very good thing that avoids you to simply forget, and the program does it every half an hour. Now I'm going to change the wall type to this internal one, which only has one layer. This time I'm going to use the finish face exterior, but it could also be the core face. It's the same, because this wall only has a structure layer. Let's start internal wall at this corner, and we are going to extend it all the way to the wall on the left. As I want it aligned with the exterior wall, I have to press the space bar here. Click there, and now press Escape. Next, I'm going to draw another one, located at 2000 mm from the exterior wall. I go to this corner, move to the right, and when the temporary distance is 2000, I click, and finally extend the wall up to the one located there. Or, sometimes it's also faster to just type the value when the dimension is on the screen. Now, I want to teach you a couple of tips to help you to place walls in specific places on your projects. First tip, to draw a wall exactly in the middle, dividing this room, I can find the midpoint here. But this time, I need to modify the location line to center line and now draw the wall. And I can either pick on the side or in the center, it's the same. Second tip, I have this wall in the project and I want to move it in order to be placed at 4000 mm from the wall at the right. The temporary dimensions that appear whenever I select an object, are editable. For example, if I click on this one, I can change that distance and the wall moves to satisfy the new value. And this is important, it's always the selected objects that move. So keep this tip in your mind. Let's proceed. I want this distance to be 4000, but the temporary dimension isn't measuring it at this moment. However, I can change the witness lines. Click and hold this circle Now I can extend the dimension to this face. Release the button. And now I can change this distance to the one that I need. It's done. Okay, it's now time to practice a little bit. I encourage you to complete this exercise by drawing these internal walls. All the necessary distances are provided here, but it's normal if you miss out on any of them. In that case, just estimate the distance yourself. The important thing is that you start practicing. Once you are done, we can proceed to the next lesson.